The history of the Chideauk site as a sanatorium, which had for many years a very significant presence of Inuit peoples, left us this wonderful legacy of artwork. So when the time came for us to vacate the Chideauk site, we had the question in mind, what will we do with this tremendously important legacy that transcends the importance of the hospital and really has become a part of the city's heritage.
The carving program where these pieces have come from really started in that period of time between 1954 and 1960 when people came down from the north to be treated. And it was really an occupational therapy program. The program started by a doctor named Hubert Ewart, who brought down stone from Northern Ontario.
And I guess they told him that they had been used, this was a kind of child's play doing this woodwork, they were used to the soapstone. So he had the brilliant idea. That was his idea.
All the works were depictions of what life was like in the Arctic. And over this period of time where they were being created, I think it provided them with this very therapeutic link to what they were missing by not being in the north.
And they sold them for very, very little. I think we all bought them at the time, gave them the gifts to people. Unfortunately, I never saved any of them. I gave them all away.
The Chideauk collection was donated to the Art Gallery of Hamilton by one of Hamilton's most important collectors and philanthropists. He's chosen to remain anonymous. The Chideauk collection will resonate with so many of our audiences, Hamiltonians, Canadians across the country, also with the education community. The study of Inuit art and culture is an important part of the Canadian curriculum, so we're hoping to bring that story to so many of the school kids, elementary, secondary, and post-secondary here in the region in Canada.
I do have memories of when the children's clinics were still here not that long ago. And oftentimes I'd just be walking by the display and I would notice small children that were here for their appointments and they'd be admiring the interesting carvings with such awe. And over these years, I've watched many people admire the art, so I think it's great that it's going to be on exhibit at the Hamilton Art Gallery.